Hey friends, we are back in the kitchen for another recipe, and today I'm gonna show you how to make the ultimate pitta pacifying wraps. They are super simple, super tasty. It is one of the recipes from my new ebook, Raw Food Ayurveda Volume 2, and today I will be giving you the recipe here. So very, very exciting. It features three different kinds of seaweed. We've got wakame flakes, we've got dulse flakes, we have some raw nori sheets, and all of these sea vegetables are gonna hit your salty taste, so be pacifying for vata in that sense without adding the sodium in salt per se. So it's a natural sodium-rich food like celery or tomatoes. As well as for the sea vegetables, they're gonna help pacify pitta and kapha because they are light and they are dry. So soaking up any excess moisture. And again, they're very nutrient dense and very tasty. So y'all, this recipe is very simple, like borderline embarrassingly simple, but so good. I had to include it because literally there were weeks where this was my dinner every single night. I didn't get sick of it. It was just so good, so simple, so satisfying, especially for those of you who have salt cravings, which that's been me, and I do best when I don't eat any salt. So these are very good for summer, very good for pitta in particular. So what we have going on here, we have our beautiful white plate onto which I'm just gonna layer butterhead lettuce. You could also use romaine lettuce leaves, anything that's gonna be a good base for the wraps. And I've got two together because some of them are a little broken. And plus, it's just like a delivery vehicle. It's a good way to get more greens in. So we're just gonna arrange them nicely in a circle. I love making circles with my food completion, y'all. So good, so good. And butterhead lettuce is pretty much my favorite right now. So then this is optional, the nori sheets. If you wanted to, you could lay them for an extra layer here. You could even do these. I had quartered the big wraps. You could even do them smaller into pieces like this if you want less nori up in there. And the nori just adds such a nice flavor and a nice unique texture. Yeah, so I like the way this is looking better with the smaller strips. Do what works for you. From a utilitarian perspective, the larger squares would probably actually help you wrap more, but this is gonna look probably a little nicer, so we'll go with that. Then I have my giant bowl, head size. We've got three English cucumbers on the smaller size. They have been spiralized, to which I added 1 tablespoon of raw wakame flakes and 1 tablespoon of dulse flakes. And I mixed that all around so that the wakame, which is quite crunchy in the bag, completely dehydrated, can then rehydrate into kind of like a noodle type existence like you would have in a seaweed salad. So I also chopped up the cucumber noodle so we don't hopefully have the really super long ones. And so I'm just gonna take some and place them gingerly, tenderly, with love and care onto our nice little wrap surfaces. And it's easy to overload your wraps, which is not a big deal, right? You'll figure out with some practice how much is the right amount and how much leaves you with a face full of noodles, which not a bad thing in the scheme of things. So we got our sea coodles up on there, looking very nice. And then I have my sliced avocado here, which for kapha dosha, you would want to be more mindful about your fat consumption, or if you're currently experiencing excess kapha, you might want to just skip this part. But I tend to tolerate avocado pretty well, especially in the summer. It's very soothing, very cooling, healthy fats, delicious, very satiating. And this one in particular was very ripe. It was like talking to me in the fridge. If you don't use me in a recipe soon, I'm just gonna go bad. And I was like, all right. So there, y'all, there we have it. Beautiful pitta pacifying wraps here. Very, very simple, very delicious. Salty, fatty, creamy, but still very, very healthy too. And it's juicy enough where you don't even really need a sauce. That being said, I am kind of the queen of sauce. I always like some dip, some sauce. So I will be making a dipping sauce recipe, which I will show you in the next video. Yeah. So like this video if you like it, subscribe for more, and let me know in the comments what you think about the recipe, and we will be in touch soon. Much love to you. Namaste.